Hey guys, in this video I'm going to do this probability and statistics problem. This is basically a continuation from the previous problem, where in the previous problem we were finding the marginal PMF from a joint PMF. In this case, in this problem, we're going to find the marginal PDF from the joint PDF. So the difference is that this is a continuous distribution, or these are continuous variables, and in the previous case, when you have PMFs, you're dealing with discrete variables. So we're going to do similar things, find a probability in C and then find the marginals in D and E. And this problem has the additional part of A and B, where we also are going to find the support and the constant C for this function. So let's go ahead and get started. So A says sketch the support of X and Y. So this just tells you where you're going to have your limits. So basically, where does this probability density function exist in 2D space? This is going to become relevant for C and then D and E. So in A, it might seem like it's a simple problem to just sketch, but we're going to use the sketch in later problems. So we have that and we're done. So this is X and this is Y. And this is basically going to help us for the support. B says find C so that F of XY is a valid joint PDF. So for questions like this, the integral over the whole support of the joint probability density function has to equal 1. So in this case, we're just going to plug in that for 0, 1, dx, dy, and 0, 3, we have cx plus cy. And we're going to solve that equal to 1 and solve for c. So I went ahead and distributed the c to the parentheses inside. So let's integrate x first. So that's going to be cx squared over 2 plus cyx from 0 to 1, dy. And then this is still dy, and we're going to plug in 1, so that's going to give c half plus cy, and then we still have to do the outer integral. When we do that, we're going to get cy over 2 plus cy squared over 2, integrate from 0 to 3, and we get 3 halves c plus 9 halves c equal to 1. That's going to give us 6c is equal to 1, which is going to give us that c is equal to 1/6. And we're done with B. Now C says find the probability that X is less than Y. So we're going to go back to the support. And now we don't want the complete, we don't want to integrate over the complete support, because that would give us 1, as we just found in B, but we want to find only the integral that will give us when X is less than Y. When we do that integral, it will give us the probability. So we're going to draw the line X is equal to Y, which is just from 0 to 1, and then this point is 1, 1. And because this is when X is less than Y, the support is everything above this line. So this whole shaded area is equal to when X is less than Y. Now that's going to give us a picture of what we need to integrate. So it's going to be another double integral. And there are multiple ways, again, this is just calc 2, I think. So there are multiple ways of getting this integral. You can either do 1 minus the triangle, and that will give you your answer, or you can just do the integral of this area that's shaded in. And again, you can kind of switch in. It doesn't matter the order if you integrate dx or dy first. So I did 0 to 1, x to 3 of 1/6x plus 1/6y, dy, dx. So I'm integrating y first and then dx, and again, it doesn't matter. And notice that we're plugging in the value of c that we got for b. So this double integral, I'm not going to write it out, but you're going to get 11/12. And if you had done 1 minus the unshaded triangle, you would have gotten 1 minus 1/12 and gotten the same answer. So we're done with C. D and E say find the marginal probability density function, and the first one we're going to find is the probability density function f of x. So the formula for the continuous case to find the marginal is that f of x is equal to the joint over dy. So every instance distance of dy. So in this case, this is going to be a single integral. So that's going to be from 0 to 3, which is, again, the support of y. And we're just going to plug in the joint formula again for the PDF. So that was 1 6x plus 1 6y dy. So that is going to give us 1 6xy plus y squared over 12 from 0 to 3. When we plug that in, we're going to get 1/2x plus 9/12. And this is over the existence of x. So x is from 0 to 1. So we do have to include that as part of our answer. And we're done with this problem, or sorry, not this problem, we're done with D. And for E, we're doing a similar formula. So f of y, the marginal of y from the joint xy, is all the support when you integrate dx. So f of xy dx. In this case, the support we already know is from 0 to 1 for all of x, and then we have 1 6x plus 1 6y dx. This gives us x squared over 12 plus xy over 6 from 0 to 1, and when we plug in 1, we're going to get 1/12 plus y over 6, and this is over the whole support, or the whole existence of y, which is from 0 to 3. And now that's the final answer for E, and we are done with this problem.